Hello and welcome to another replaycast. Yeah, well, since we don't play clan battles at the moment, I'm lacking a bit of these replays where I could make some videos out of. So I'm feeding you with more, yeah, let's say, in this case, more sad games, random games. But I stick to my plan to feature some more unpopular ships or not so often featured ships. And that is the, for example, the Duca da Aosta, which is the tier 6 Italian light cruiser. Premium, of course, since there's no Italian ship line out yet. And yeah, I like the ship. I liked it. I bought it when it came out. But I have to say, it can be challenging, especially if you are in tier 8 matchmaking. The reason why it is because it has really a short range of only 14 kilometers, and it's not as good against BBs as, for example, like fire starters, like the Bujoni that can do it on range, or Aoba, all these good fire starters. You have good reload, okay-ish guns and penetrations. Issue is you have a really low fire chance on the Italian HE, while you have a pretty good AP. Not as good as the German one, but still very good. The 152 millimeters here are also pretty fast firing. You have 7.5 seconds reload, I think. And the initial muzzle velocity of these guns is almost at 1,000 meters per second, so that's pretty fast. But they have some air drag, so they aren't as good as other shells on range, for example, because they are so lightweight. But for close areas, especially against DDs or lightly armored cruisers in close combat, it's really nice. A bit troll stuff are the 12 km slow-moving torps that you have on each side, a triple launcher. Yeah, you just throw them without aiming too much. I think it's just like, okay, hit or miss, but you don't care about them. It's fire and forget. In this game, you will see a lot of them. But I can tell you already, I didn't hit once. But yeah, that's not about this game. So we are here on Neighbors, standard battle, tier 5 to tier 7 matchmaking. Two carriers, Saipan. What you just maybe already noticed is that Duca has two consumables. Builds. It has Hydro and it has defensive AA. Which comes in handy. I mean, you won't shoot down many planes with this defensive AA because the AA on this Italian cruiser is pretty garbage, to be honest. So, nothing to brag about. But yeah, as I said, this ship is not like for or made for anti-air defense or like good against battleships. It's mostly against destroyers and cruisers, and it's of course fast for that reason. Has a hydro slot. And yeah, that's it probably what it is about. And you don't want to play it in the middle. And initially you have to be really cautious. You don't have the most amount of hit points. You have spaced armor, same like for example the French cruisers. But that's it. You can, especially Scharnhorst or so low caliber. How are they called? Low caliber crew, no, battle cruisers, battleships like the Scharnhorst, for example, they can be a real pain in the ass. They have enough penetration to pen you everywhere, and they are fast firing. And yeah, penetration values on the Scharnhorst, for example, are pretty good. Of course, the other ones are deadly as well, so don't underestimate normal BB shells. They can hurt a lot as well. But Duca, in my opinion, at least is a bit trollish when it comes to that, so not too much to fear about. All right, so yeah, since I didn't see any DD yet. Speaking of, hello, Mr. Gallant. Just in the vicinity. Okay, now I instantly pop Hydro. To see where the torps are off far from. And as soon as I pass them, I go full ham and aggressive. Also popping AA to shoot down the fighters of the Saipan, but Saipan just vanishes. So fine with me. Alright, so since he's still in the smoke, that's fine with me. Then I'm going and try to kill him as quick as possible, because that's what the Duca is really good at. But the Gallant isn't that stupid, he is just vanishing. And there we have another customer, and this is an Ochotnik. But Ochotnik has an issue, this is just like a bit like a YOLO ship. Because, yeah, it can wreck you pretty hard if you are in the 4.5 kilometer range. So I'm staying outside of this and try to have him in my Hydro range, but sadly he slipped out of it, and I slipped away. I ran too far away, which in the end cost me his. Can't see him anymore. So that was a bit unlucky, because I was about to finish him, and my Hydro just ran off. Which reminds me that I should maybe run Hydro module if it's possible. I don't know, but yeah, in this situation it comes in really, really handy. Yeah, the reason I'm not charging is for sure because the Ochotnik has such a massive torpedo power that I won't survive that for long. Our Kneisenau is just making was getting known to it, because it seems as if he does not know. Otherwise he would have not. I don't know why he's even turning in now. This is just like literally suicide what he's doing. I'm staying in the vicinity as soon as we get a glimpse on one of these guys that we can that I can help the Kneisenau, but he's probably already dead. He's flooding. Okay. And are the Gallant torps. And he's like, maybe the Kneisenau has this strange module which gives him like this 3 kilometer range from which from what he can see the enemy ships in smoke. I don't know how it's called in English. So Hotnik is up, but he won't survive this. Yep. So yeah, with this issue dealt, it's typical standard battle. What are 2DDs doing at this point? And yeah, as I said, Kneisenau won't survive, he got a flooding, and that's it for him. So, next issue. Lyon, Nagato are coming from the south. Nobody is caring about them, and some of the... Yeah, we have a lonely King George who's going down, or is running from them, asked for help, but since all of my team, including this King George, would will be take a big part in the end of this game, including him, who's totally out of position, absolutely useless, can't help because we are all up here. So I try to help at least as long as soon as I can by going straight to him. That's the good thing about the Duca, you can play it on the flanks, and it's fast enough to relocate. But sadly we couldn't, there was no chance of relieving that poor KGB down there who was fighting alone. Yeah, then we have the Ranger who is he's doing his job, I think. At least he's striking. But he's also auto-dropping, so nothing too special. By the way, if you wonder why I make so much damage, I have IFHE slotted on this ship, so it's absolutely necessary in my opinion to deal at least a lot of damage, since you don't get many fires, as I said before. We'll go over the captain build after the the replay. So for all you people who are interested, I will show it then, and also the modules, so you have a proper clue what I'm talking about or what I'm spec my Duca like. Okay, that Duke is going down. You don't kill some, fine. Alright. So back. Nobody seems to realize that we need to go to the our base, but yeah. Typical random battle with typical players without any awareness. Our Leon is for whatever reason heading towards their cap. I mean, that can work, but I'm not a big fan, especially when they have a Saipan around. Checking the speed. Could have switched to AP here, honestly, but yeah, I don't intend to stay too long here because I'm still spotted. And now I try to get undetected, but the issue is that Leon can already spot me. And Nagato as well. All stations reporting the position of a strategic target. So I'm waiting until undetected. Oh yeah, I totally forgot about to talk about the detection range is also pretty good with 10.3. I think it's the best. Except for the... what is it? The Leander? Best concealment? I think for its tier. So I think even better than the Oba, but I'm not 100% sure, don't get me on that. Also, I'm communicating with the Anshan, letting him know. Yeah, that was, by the way, a misclick, so I didn't intend to use my Hydro here. That we should smoke up and kill that Leon. Carrier is already going for him, but yeah. Leon is the biggest threat. 16 cannons, that's nothing you want to joke about. I mean, Britannia and Nagato also are pretty deadly, but Leon is the most deadly, in my opinion, right now. So I'm thanking this Anshan for doing this, because that helps a lot to deal damage without getting shot at. And as a cruiser, especially when you like still have 3 full HP, almost full HP now, battleships, yeah, then you take everything you can to deal damage without getting punished for it. I wonder if the Leon shot at us. It doesn't seem like... he shot at the Anshan, and I think he slipped out the Anshan, so that was pretty unlucky for him. Yeah, good shot there by the Leon. Thing we can do. Also, I launched one of these troll torpedoes, that's how I like to call them. they don't deal much damage, they have not such a good fire chance, but lightning chance, but they are fun to play. Of course, starting a plane, because since I lost vision, of course I will do that. It seems as if they are targeting something else. Now it's Ranger. Lucky for us that the enemy's Mayan is AFK. Okay, I got one fire on the Leon. Means if I can get another one, he should be dead. Okay, Leon finished the Nuremberg, which made it quite good for us. So now I have an issue. Okay, that Leon had damage come up. That's the first issue. So I need to get him out of the way as quick as possible. So I have a King George up here, if you see it. And yeah, I just count on him that he's realizing what this is here all about. So 308 HP and he got his heal up. So that's really, really, really big issue for me now. Another Troll Torps on the Britannia there. And hoping the best. I just want to finish this Leon. Now I'm using damage con, because two fires are a bit too much. Then of course I have these torps I need to dodge, I have the shells that I need to dodge. So practically everything. And the King George is even going further away, and I'm like, what the hell is going on with this guy? So, maybe you saw that, I have expert loader on this ship, just because of that reasons. And broadside Miyoko. I mean, I ignored him. Normally, I shouldn't have ignored him, and if he would have been smart, he would have killed me already, or like, devastated me, or like burnt me down already. But he rather likes to torp, so that is pretty lucky for me. Yeah, Leon just sent some wishes from down there, because I couldn't finish him, and the King George can't finish him myself. So yeah, So the struggle for this is going. So I need to angle northwards, because the Bretagne to my... What is it? From the cap is also able to shoot me in my broadside, so I need to run now northwards. Which means I can't apply any pressure towards the cap anymore. Have my hydro up, so in case there are torps coming, so I know where I not should turn to. Yeah. Again a switch on AP. I just... Miyoko's absolutely oblivious. Unbelievable that you can play like this, and he doesn't get punished. The King George is running even further away. I'm totally alone against like 1, 2. Okay, the Nagato isn't shooting me. That's one thing. Or did he? I think no. The Nagato already shot me. So scored another citadel. Switching to HE because he's turning away again, hugging the border because there's nothing else I could do anymore. Okay, maybe I can finish this Miyoko this time. That would be great. Yeah. King George is running even further away. Great. So yeah, can't shoot the Nagato, and I need to reset the Bretagne, because otherwise they will cap through. And of course Nagato shoots me. And of course torps are incoming. Still. So I'm trying to get into a position where I can comfortably get out. Yeah, I'm turning again in because I was worried of more torps, but I realized, nah, not... It's fine. Yeah, King George still running. I'm complaining in the chat. I mean, at this point I was like, really, guy? Man, why can't you help me? We have this in the back. We just have this in the back. Why can't you just bring in your HP? You have a lot of HP to bring in. And we win this. But no, he's running. And now he's coming back for whatever reasons. He realized it. So, staying slightly angled as much as I can. And shooting. To reset the Bretagne as much as I can. Or as often as I can. But of course I'm forced away. Even if I would like to turn, there is nothing. Because I'm... close at the edge, I'm not really fast, and I'm getting pounded by two BBs at the same time. So it's just pure luck what happens here, because it's lucky that the Nagato is shooting HE still. Meanwhile, I achieve to get a Confederate, fine with that, but I'm totally stressed now, because now we have the Nagato in the cap. And here I probably made a mistake by shooting further on instead of like maybe getting undetected and turn closer to reset the Nagato. But I'm a bit too focused right now on this Bretagne and just forgot about this. But yeah, some trolls, torps. Just in the vicinity where I expect him to go. So one fire, slowing down, turning in to dodge more shells. Absolutely stressful game right now. Of course AR kicks totally in right now, so I'm having a pretty good reload. That's all. High caliber. But doesn't help, because I'm still running away from our cap, and it looks as if the enemy was able to reset our Lyon as well. So I use my spotter plane, dodging the last volley of the Bretagne. Hopefully he dies, and then my plan is go as quick as possible towards our base. But if you look at the timer in the upper right corner, you see That's probably gonna be a heartbreaker again. And yeah, what can I say? Then you get like blamed for you have a plan, Costa. Yeah, I have a plan. But I can't do much if my BB friend isn't or is refusing to help me out. And that's really an issue, and I hated it so much when I saw that. And we are losing this just because of him. So I want to thank you, this KGB, who was the absolute useless potato I met in a while, because I think even a bad player could have or would have realized after like the pinging and what was going on that he is that we might need to reset, or that I might need help, or whatever the cap resetting, whatever. I think he would have realized, but this guy, he had two tomatoes on his eyes, how we like to say it in Germany. Absolutely, yeah, pathetic. And that was an easy, terrible game. But I couldn't. I mean, of course, you can say I made a mistake by not turning in, getting undetected and turning in early enough. But I was really trying to get. I mean, I would lose like 20 seconds of not shooting, then turning, then maybe even get catch because the Bretagne is somewhere around. So there was always a risk of getting caught and maybe not even reaching in time. So I can't say that. Maybe there's was a chance for me to reset them, because as the Leon who was in the enemy cap said, it was definitely only one reset we needed. But yeah, that's the result. Another defeat, another help from a helpful battleship player. So Mr. And he was not even the worst. I mean, look at this. There are still people that are worse than this guy. I'm always bamboozled how you can be even worse, but yeah. The three players on top, even that King George, the other one died that early, but he couldn't do much because he was hunted down by two by a lot of battleships and probably got striked by the Saipan as well. So yeah, this Merlin or whatever guy just cost us the game. So I want to thank you in this video as well, Mr. Merlin. You did a great job there. Yeah, 1500 base XP in a tier 5 to tier 7 game. Yeah. What can you say, right? The other guy, the Leon, has 7 kills and less HP, XP, yeah, probably because he's top tier. Okay, let's go on to the detailed report. Yeah, there's not something special to say. I mean, it was said that I couldn't finish the Leon. Yeah, most of the damage came from the HE, of course, and then some from the AP when I had the chance. Potential damage 1.8. Normally, you don't want to gain that much in the Duca because it's really too squishy. to sustain this, but if you can dodge all the shells, then okay, you get a good time. And I was pretty lucky. I mean, let's face the truth, if the enemy battleships would have aimed a bit better, then I would have been down way, way earlier, and Nagato, for example, shooting AP or so. But they didn't, so yeah. Yeah, let's quickly switch over to the captain build and the modules, and then I'm ending this video. All right, as promised, yeah, here the captain build, which is of course not the one I would say it's the most optimal one, but it's the one I like to play the most with. So I'm quickly explaining why. First of all, priority target should be clear. Then you go adrenaline rush. Expert marksman is optional because you don't need it in the beginning. The turret traverse is quite fine enough. Then you need demolition expert to get a better fire chance because it's really poor on the ship. And then you go Concealment Expert, sorry. Next one is IFHE. And then I went for Expert Marksman. And last but not least, Expert Loader. Two points left. I think I will go then for Jack of All Trades, I guess. Or maybe Torpedo Acceleration, but that depends. Because I like these troll torpedoes, to be honest, and I don't want to reduce that range. But I'm not sure yet. I think AFT doesn't make any sense because the AA is pretty garbage, and yeah, RPF could be a thing if you want to play it actively as a DD hunter. I wouldn't mind that, I think. So, yeah. You can try out a bit what you like and what not, and what you find is useful, and so on. Okay, then let's go over to the modules. Pretty simple. Debatable, you can use maybe spotter plane aircraft, especially helpful when you are good at shooting with spotter plane. And if you are ending up in a tier 8 matchmaking, you need all the range you can get, and as long as you can get it. So, definitely not a bad choice. Oh, yeah, here is it. Hydroacoustic Search. So, I want to have this one. I feel that makes a lot of more sense. It would have helped me the last game I showed you, definitely. And then, of course, the mandatory AA range increasement, since you don't need the accuracy, in my opinion. And yeah, better radar shift is always recommended, especially when you're in fighting DDs. You wanna try and avoid torpedoes whenever you spot them. And yeah, that's it basically about the Dooka, this nice little ship. Okay, thanks for watching this. Hope you enjoyed it. Even though I didn't enjoy the game itself, at least the ending was like, oh my god, you did everything what you could, but you couldn't do it. Or you couldn't carry again. But yeah, that's how it is sometimes. Wanted to share it with you. Hopefully, it's interesting enough to share it. And yeah, see you next time, and hopefully, with some new clan battles soon. Bye bye.